would have been a history major. I actually ended up taking economics, but all my subjects were economic history and all that. So I'm a big fan of everybody here today. And I honestly thank you from the bottom of my heart for making history exciting. It is not an interesting subject to most, and I think the only reason why I love history is I have a vivid imagination. My mom is a preschool teacher, so I just grew up in that environment. So I remember when I actually had to start memorizing dates, it all went past me because I would really dig deep and imagine what was going on when I read these names. And so if the exam happened to be about names and dates, I would not do well. But I normally was impressive enough with my imagination to be able to give a good recitation on something that it gave a good enough impression to the teacher. And so years later, I got into historical novels, and then even years later, through Netflix, I don't watch that much TV, but through Netflix or iTunes, I've downloaded so many amazing documentaries and stories that really bring to life where we all came from. And that really has been one of the principles. My brother and I, by the way, if you look at the official program, it's my brother Alan Cayetan who should be standing here, so I'm not Alan. Alan is our new Secretary of Foreign Affairs, and I think he's like really loaded with events. So I was supposed to speak on the women's, opening up the women's section, but I'm happy to speak about everything. And as I was saying, Alan and I come from a history where our father always tells us, don't forget to look for where you came from. And we've all heard that. In Filipino, huwag natin kalimutan, tumingin, saan tayo nanggaling, sa ating pinanggalingan. Huwag matakot, huwag kalimutan, lumingon sa pinanggalingan. Never forget, never be afraid to look for where you came from. And one of my battles, for the sake of our foreign visitors, has been preserving our heritage and cultural sites. I think you might be brought to our Rizal Monument. It is where our national hero's remains are. It was dedicated to him, I think, some 100 years ago or so. And the battle was, there was a big building that was being behind it, and it was destroying the whole Rizal. So we fought for that over a period of about 3 years. And it actually started as a very lonely fight. It was just between heritage experts and I, who happen to be the chairman of the Committee of Education, Arts and Culture. That's why I got into it. And then because of social media, it turned out to be a nationwide fight. So many young people, older people, a lot of people were concerned. And we lost the battle in the Supreme Court, but it is something that I feel was a success in its own right because it brought the importance of heritage and culture to everyone. So there's so much to say, but it's more interesting in there. And so let me just say that I'm just as excited as everybody else. But one last message, bloggers, to the visitors, you have a unique opportunity in this time to become part of history, to write history because of social media, because of your opportunity to document what you see through your hand, through the pen, through your cell phone. Who knows, one day, 100 years from now, somebody might dig up your blog, somebody might dig up your Instagram photo, and make a whole story out of it. So be true to history, be creative, but don't be afraid to document what you see, because you may be the instrument that our future generation will look to understand where we are then, which is our future now, but their history then. So on that note,
bye.
Everybody enjoy, and thank you for having me. I'm very excited.